and I'm here to say the power belongs to the people. And the enemy is the finance minister. And yes, we were arrested, and we will do it again. Because until the punitive bill that has been forced on the throats of Kenyans and on our neck is clear, word for word, we are going to do this again. Again, reject the finance bill. And for our MPs, we are expecting you to vote no to the finance bill.
Are you voting no?
I'll
just echo what she said, and the enemy is the finance rule again, and we're not going to leave here until everyone is released, and we not tolerate such bullying from the government and the police, but we need to make sure everyone is safe, and thank you guys for everything. You guys are who you think you are. Thank you so much, and how are you? I promise they're going to vote no. That's what matters. The finance is rejecting companies. Thank you so much.
And thank you, Kenyans, for showing up.
This is Sandeli sana. First of all, all Kenyans ambao wamejitokeza leo kwa maandamano. Jambo ningependa kusema ni kwamba polisi wajatuanda vizuri. Tumepigwa tear gas, tumepigwa kutika, wengine wameumia. Please handle us like your fellow Kenyans, because you are Kenyans like us. As much as wewe uko kazi, pia angalia ule mtu unapiga ni Mkenya kama wewe. Na nataka kusema asante sana kwa Wakenya kujitokeza, because hali ni mbaya, hali ni ngumu. So siwezi kaa pale ni nyamaze. I'm not here as a content creator, I'm here as a Kenyan. Because this thing is affecting all Kenyans, not a particular sector of people. So kwa Kenya wote, tukiitwa tafadhali tutokeni, sababu hii ni maisha yetu ya sasa na ya baadaye.
Madam President.
So I'm standing on behalf of the members of the society of Kenya, because the members who have voted, we have held meeting here and we've been able to negotiate with the host, yes, get most of the members out of Freeborn, and we're happy to see that the numbers are streaming out, and we also got positive feedback also from Kakunji. The members are also, they have been able to be released. And so we ask that irrespective of the challenges that we had today, we hope that most members will be released by tonight, that they will not spend at this police cells, because we believe they are being held unlawfully. They were exercising their democratic right to peacefully protest until they were arrested. With regards to our members who may have been injured, members who have suffered violence by virtue of action by the police officers, we are sharing on our Twitter handles the toll-free line that members can go and report, and also come at the Lost Society of Kenya and report those issues. LSK will be coming out in large numbers. Our members will be offering their services at pro bono to ensure that those who have suffered any injury, we can bring those particular police officers to court. And we will hold those who are in command for command responsibility. Or a duty to the Kenyans, you have a duty to the Constitution and the National Police Service Act, that you act within the ambit, and use of excessive force is not allowed in this country. And we are saying that impunity shall not be allowed. And so we are happy that most have been released and some are still being released. And we ask that even at Kampunji, that Boniface Mwangi should be released. He's a member he's a Kenyan who was exercising his democratic rights. Let's ensure that we uphold the rule of law at all times in this country. Thank you.
Do we have the numbers of those who are arrested and those who have been released? Numbers.
We had almost 300 that were arrested. Unless I confirm with our numbers, both here at Kilimani in Kampunji, there are 283 that were arrested, but unless we confirm with numbers from Kampunji as well as here is when we can say how many have been released. Kilimani, there were about 9 and they were all released. So we are happy with what happened at Kilimani. The OCS was quite supportive, and so we hope that most members can be released by tonight.
First and foremost, I'll begin by just congratulating the Law Society of Kenya. Mheshimiwa Babu, thank you so much for coming to stand in solidarity with the all who came to stand with on their rights. And I think demonstration is one of the rights, or the freedom of expression is one of the things that is enshrined in the Constitution of Kenya. And I think it's a high time that also the police should understand that if these people were not with any intention to harm anyone, it was their right to demonstrate whatever they are thinking. And from where we sit as the members of parliament, we are going to ask other, as the Kenya Kwanza MPs. I know they have been hoodwinked to accept with the few changes on eco levy and the bread, just to show, to blackmail them. But the thing, what the Kenyans want, they don't want that thing called the finance bill. We already know that we have the Finance Act right now that is really stressing Kenyans. And by bringing in another finance bill to come and generate another 300 billion, I think this is injustice to Kenyans. And when you look at the budget, the way it has been split, it is not even, and when the president said that people should live within their means. So I think it is high time that as members of parliament, we have to reject that finance bill in totality and start even revising that the Finance Act of 2023-2024 that is right now stressing. Even when they say that they want to remove the eco levy on locally made whatever items, you find like even it's going to be very expensive for our young ladies who using the human hair or whatever to make them, and even the iPads.
I think we are done. Thank you very much, members of the press.
Okay.
That's the last one. iPad.